Hi, Jürgen.
Hi, Vincent.
Nice to meet you. You work at the housing association Eigenhaard.
Yeah, in Amsterdam.
I wouldn't know how to translate that into English.
Yeah, Eigenhaard or?
Own hearth or something?
Yeah, no, Eigenhaard is international.
It's international. But it's one of the biggest housing associations in Amsterdam, and actually in the Netherlands.
In the Netherlands.
About 60,000 properties?
It will be approximately 60,000, but not only housing, but also offices, small offices, or garage.
Small shops maybe also.
Mainly depending on what's in the neighborhood for housing.
Yeah, and you're considered as one of the front runners on sustainability.
For a few years.
How come and why is it so important for you? To act like a sustainable housing association.
Yeah, 10 years ago we started with an innovation project for increasing the sustainability.
Yeah.
We want to have an because sustainability was a new issue and there was a lot of what's wrong, what's good. And we want to know in working with it what's wrong and what's good, because of the expansion to other projects.
Yeah.
We started a pilot project for that, Stads & Overtoom, and with this project we want to have more knowledge about sustainability.
Okay, so actually it's also still a learning experience.
Yeah, still learning at this moment.
And could you tell us a bit about what you are trying in Overtoom, in Stads & Overtoom?
In Stads & Overtoom, we have to focus sustainability as reducing energy, but also the use of circularity about materials we combine this in one project.
So you focus actually on both energy efficiency and resource efficiency.
Sustainability is more in a lot of projects it's only energy, but we have all in 10 years ago circularity was not even mentioned.
That's true.
And we started with in this project to combine those two.
Yeah. Talking about energy efficiency, what kind of measures are you thinking of, or are you actually doing already?
We want to reduce energy because of making it affordable for our low income tenants.
Yeah.
And our approach is the Trias Energetica approach, which first of all reducing energy, the need for energy.
Yeah.
The second is to provide with sustainable energy like solar cells.
Okay.
Third of all is reducing the rest energy need of the traditional energy, like oil or gas, and so on.
So fossil, to reduce the fossil energy as much as possible.
Yeah, as much as possible. I think we want to expand it.
Yeah, yeah. So we talked a bit about energy efficiency, but you said you also work on resource efficiency. What kind of measures should we think of then?
In Stads & Overtoom, our main purpose was to reuse all the materials we demolish.
Okay.
Because demolishing a project isn't so energy efficient as we want, if we do, then reuse the materials you have for. Our approach is 100%, but that isn't possible because you have asbestos, you have some other materials you can't reuse.
Some materials you just don't want to use again.
Maybe in the future, but at this moment not, because of what is possible. But in Stads & Overtoom, we use 99% of the old materials and new materials.
99%?
We make from them new materials like new concrete, new bricks, and so on.
That's extremely high because I've heard of some other pilot projects and they come up to 60% of reusing the material, but 99%, that's really special.
That's if you have the good people that we work mm-hmm. on, we work for this project on Oranje. They also yeah. are a famous engineer in Delft. You have to look at materials and what is possible. Some things are not possible, mainly because they are connected too much together. That's the reason why we could, because of the building environment of the 50s, it was possible to reuse a lot of materials.
Great. And do you have other examples of how you actually implement principles of the circular economy in your housing management?
Like reusing kitchens. The main issue for us is to make the circular as quick as possible. Like materials, but reusing as elements or
as they are.
As they are, without another work on it to reuse it. Like kitchens, like in sanitary and so on.
And you started off by saying that one of the reasons why you pay so much attention to sustainability is because of your clients, for example, because it makes their dwellings more affordable, particularly if they have less costs on energy. But how do you involve your clients in these processes?
Sustainability isn't a great issue for a lot of tenants for us.
Okay.
Because they want a new house which is affordable, which is which could be. Affordability is the biggest issue. Sustainability is for our tenants not the biggest issue because affordability is their main issue. Like what's next day on the plate?
Exactly.
We can eat. Yeah. But we use sustainability in making affordable housing.
Okay.
And we introducing them to sustainability by looking at how they can do it for themselves better. Making it, giving them more information about energy use and
so they can change their own behavior and that's a way to become more sustainable even without adaptation of the housing stock.
And it is not possible for us. I think that the tenants won't listen to us. They are energy coaches, which are neighbors in a complex.
Yeah.
And they could give some examples of how to make it affordable, make it lower energy use in houses.
So in a way you're helping the tenants to involve each other in this process. That's great. Well, it's nice to hear about your practice on sustainability, very inspiring.
Thank you.
And thank you for sharing it with us.
Okay.